feeling the turtleneck. You know what I mean?
Anyway, hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I am Britt, creator of The Style Shaker, your guide to greener and cleaner beauty, all things like that. I am back with a roundup of some light coverage hacks. They're not necessarily light coverage foundations, but these are the products I use to get really nice light amount of coverage that looks natural and yet sort of evens out skin tone. It's a question that I have actually received quite a bit. I have not addressed it, so that's why I'm here today. You want to learn about what I do to get to that little light coverage look, then stick around and let's get into it. Okay, so here's what I do. It's all about the combination. I usually combine things. Sometimes it's a liquid with a powder. Sometimes it's two liquids. There's just things happening here. And I just, you know, I dabble in the morning because that's kind of my happy time. And this is what I have come up with. So first, there is the combination of what I've recently been doing. This is the Suntegrity Impeccable Skin. You could use their 5-in-1 tinted moisturizer as well. You can use a tinted moisturizer of most any kind, I would say, that's more moisturizer than tint, if that makes sense. This is fantastic to use on its own, but I also like to add a little bit more color. So what I will do is take a fuller coverage foundation. You can really use most anything that you have that is moisturizing and liquid. I like to use the 14E Aloe Nourish Foundation. This is in color Sunkissed. It is a little dark on me, so this diffuses the color a little bit as well, so I can wear it because I actually really, really like it. I will put this, kind of the majority of this, in the palm on my hand, and then a little dab of this foundation. You can use a brush or a kabuki. I like to use my fingers because it gets all the product on the face, and then I'll buff it out a little bit. Having the moisturizer with that really is kind of a nice combination. Again, it doesn't have to be a tinted moisturizer. You could use just a regular old face moisturizer. You just don't want it to be too oily. You can try the Pie. I love that calming rosehip and chamomile moisturizer, or your favorite everyday face moisturizer will get you there. Just squeeze a little bit of foundation on there and you're good to go. If you do feel like you're too shiny, you can always set on top with a translucent powder to keep that sort of natural, easygoing look. Very light dusting. One of my favorites is the, where is it? Sorry. is the 14E setting powder. I know I'm very 14E heavy right now, but they are one of my favorites. Very light dusting goes a long way here, and it's very effective. If you need to kind of suppress the shine and you have oilier skin, this is more matte, this foundation, so it's kind of a magical combination for people like me who have combo skin types. So that's the first route I would suggest. The second is just using one product, and I have talked about it pretty much ad nauseum. It is on my favorites page back on the website. It is the Inika BB Cream. Like, there is nothing left on here. This is color tan. I think I'm almost at the end of it, so I've got to replace it. This is my one and done, get out the door and go. I can put on a moisturizer beforehand to sheer it out a little bit. I never find that I need to do that. P.S. There's totally construction going on in the background, so if you hear that, sorry. Anyway, this is just kind of my go-to. It's more of an investment in price, but I have to tell you, I really, really like it. If you want to smooth things out, you can try it with their primer. You know, primer, I'm neither here nor there necessarily, but it's just my go-to. You don't even have to combine anything here. If you do want a SPF with it, you could use a moisturizing SPF like the 5-in-1 from Suntegrity, or you could kind of boost this a little bit with the MyShell Sun Shield Liquid Skin Tint. Sorry, I totally read it. Sun Shield Liquid. This is an older bottle. I just got the new bottle with the dropper, but it has an SPF 50 in it, nude. You can get the translucent one. This is one of my all-time favorites. It's a great, great product to add into anything that you have that you want to have some SPF in, and you want a little bit of a boost of moisture. This also is not going to be super greasy, so this is better for oily skin types. As far as I'm concerned, I did not find this to be oily or greasy or heavy. So if you're looking and listening to me talk about putting a moisturizer with something and you're like, that's not gonna work for me, then I'm gonna have to set it and then it's gonna look really cakey. This might be the route you wanna go down for a nicer coverage for that type of skin. So yeah, you could add this to this, but it really doesn't need it. But I will keep holding this because this is one of my all-time favorites. It could also be a one and done, but what I like to do here is take this and then I will apply a powder on top of it, like the Alima Pure Satin Finishing Powder in Ami or Amy. You could use a powder foundation and just use a very small amount on your brush and then dust it on top of the MyShell Sun Tint. These two combined might be a little drying for some skin types. For oily skin types, this might be your holy grail. I don't know. But For those who need a little bit more moisture, I would say, you know, you could keep this in there or you could drop that out, do a different thing for SPF and use the 100% Pure BB Cream. This is luminous. It's like glowy and magical and wonderful. And at first I tried it and I thought there is no way this is going to work for me, but I actually ended up loving it. So I popped this on and then I dust a little bit of foundation, powdered foundation on top. Again, very light hand on the foundation and it's pretty fantastic. I love the look that it gives. Those are kind of all of the products that I use. I didn't want to overload you with too many products. I just wanted to give you the different combinations that have worked for me. Most recently, because it's been really dry out and it's cold, I've been using the Impeccable Skin and a moisturizer and the 14E. I also want to add that I do use an oil, a nourishing face oil, which is very, very lightweight, but it is still an oil. I will do that with my Gua Sha tool in the morning before I apply any of my makeup. So I have a base on my skin of a facial oil that's already kind of soaked into the skin and the skin is plumped from the Gua Sha. So that really helps, I think, with the moisture. If you are severely dry and you're looking at this stuff and you're like, that's not enough for me, I would recommend sticking to your moisturizing routine in the beginning and then popping some things on top. And I am keeping it super simple here. It's really just working with and enhancing what you have, and you don't need 17 products to do it. You just don't, in my opinion. It can be easy. It's like easy button time, you know what I mean? So that's all I have for this video. Hopefully you found this helpful. If you did, then make sure you give it a thumbs up to support the channel. And as always, don't forget to subscribe so you never miss another video like this one. And oh, don't forget to tell me, what is your favorite light coverage foundation option or just combination? I have some light coverage foundations, but like this I felt is what I personally do more often than using one product. This is me telling you what I actually do and not just picking the foundations. That's why I didn't just pick a foundation and serve it up to you, because that wouldn't be what I'm actually doing. And I will see you guys right back here real soon. Until then, bye.